Hello, hello, brothers and sisters. How are you? Your sister, your girl, your sister, a princess from Princess Sewaka Ministry. I haven't been here in a while. I hope all has been well with you. Things have been okay with me. Let's just say a quick prayer before I give this message as the Spirit of God lead me to do today. Lord Jesus Christ, I call upon your heavenly presence to dominate this message that I'm about to give. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, O Lord, that it bring healing and deliverance and direction to anyone who comes across this video. May your spirit, the Spirit of God, be upon this video and reach those that you want it to reach. The name of Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, today I just want to speak about something called God's announcement. God's announcement. In life, sometimes when we do things, or when you are into whatever business, maybe you're waiting for your rightful partner, or you know something. You're waiting on God for it, yet it seems that it's not coming. You feel God has not has abandoned you. You feel time is going fast. You look at other people. Oh, wow, this person, you could even be a man or woman, or you could be a pastor, could be an evangelist. You could be somebody like me who God is giving messages regularly to go and deliver to people. And you may feel that maybe you feel the right people are not putting a demand on the grace, Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. On that grace that God has given, has put upon you. And sometimes it is natural, right? It is natural, it is human for people to feel discouraged. Sometimes you may even want to give up. Listen, there have been many times when I had wanted to just give up. I wanted to give up on this ministry, and but each time, no matter how far or how much I try to run away, God always pulls me back. God always reminds me the reason, the purpose why He has called me to be doing what I'm doing. If you look at the book of Luke, I believe chapter 9, verse 34, 35, someplace around that place. When, Jesus, after he has gone to John the Baptist, went over there, went to John the Baptist, and he was baptized. Then the Holy Spirit came upon Jesus like a dove, and there's the Holy Spirit speaking, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." And there's something else that is, was said there. It said, "Hear ye him. Hear ye him." When the grace of God comes, and after that baptism, the Bible records that Jesus was driven into the wilderness. Was driven into the wilderness where he went to 40 days and 40 nights fasting. And after that, his ministry blew. So there's a reason why Jesus was delayed up to that time when for John the Baptist to be the one to bring him, to baptize him, to announce him, some kind of an announcement to the world. There's always a timing for everything. There's the right time for everything. There's the right time for every purpose. There's the right time for every grace. There's the right time for that business to grow, to blow. There's the right time for that ministry to spring. There is the right time for that grace that you carry for men and women to begin to seek for it. Excuse me, to seek that grace that you carry. So I'm here to encourage you not to give up. If you look at the book of 2 Timothy, I believe chapter 1 verse 12. Chapter 1 verse 12, it says, "For I know who I believe, and I am persuaded." Who do you believe? That calling that you have, that musical career, that you singing beautiful songs, but nobody seems to care about your song. Nobody is calling you for concert. Nobody is calling to even do a little opening, whatever, dance or something. You know that the God has called you with a purpose for ministry or for whatever it is, yet you feel that nobody is seeing that grace on you. It does not matter. Who do you believe? Whose report do you believe? What report do you believe? Do you want to listen, open your ears to that negative voice of the enemy, who is Satan, that is speaking in your ears all the time, saying, look at you, you're a failure, nobody wants you, nobody likes you, nobody wants to be around you? Is that the report that you want? Or do you want to hearken to the voice of God that is speaking to you on the other side, saying, wait for my timing. Wait, let me announce you. Wait, I know the right time to announce you. Wait, I know the right place to announce you. Wait, I know the right way to announce you. I'm here to encourage you, somebody, no matter what it is that you are doing, that business, that whatever, that ministry, that musical career, that fashion design career, that grace that God has put into you, that you feel that nobody is interested in right now, wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord, because God has a perfect time for you. He has a perfect time for me. Has a perfect time for each and every one of us. For I know who I believe, and I am persuaded. That is in 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 19, I believe. 1 Timothy 1, verse 12. So I'm here to encourage you, my brothers and sisters. You cannot give up on your belief. You cannot give up on your faith. You cannot give up on the fact that that grace that you carry, that great idea that you carry and you feel it has not been realized. Sometimes you don't even need to be knocking on doors. Sometimes you keep trying to announce yourself. You're wasting your time. Just do not give up on that grace that you carry. Continue while doing that. Give it to God in prayer. Hearken to the voice of God that is giving you that encouragement. Hearken to the voice of God that is speaking to you, telling you to wait. Wait, my son. Wait, my daughter. I know the right time for you. I know the right place for you. I know the right people for you. Sometimes when we've been too much haste, when we've been too much haste just because we want to be like other people, you don't even know how those people God are doing whatever they're doing. There's so many spirits out there. I'm not trying to trivialize the fact that God is the one, the ultimate lifter of men. God is the ultimate lifter of men. But I'm trying to encourage you, do not give up on your belief in God's timing, your belief in God's purpose. Say, for I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you. God already knows the plans he has for you. He already knows the plans he has for that career. He knows the plans he has for that industry. He knows the plans he has for that job search. You're looking for a job for so long. You're about to give up in life. God has a better plan for you. May the Lord Almighty bless these words into your hearts. Thank you, Jesus. Let us pray quickly. Father, Lord Jesus Christ, I pray, Lord, all those who will come across this video, Lord Jesus Christ, I pray that you give them peace of mind. Pray that you give them the grace to wait on you. As they wait on you, Lord Jesus Christ, I pray that you open their spiritual eyes to see the greater plan that you have for them. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord Jesus, as you opened your eyes, remove every obstacle that is blocking their ways. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus, for answered prayers. In Jesus' name. God bless you, brothers and sisters. I'll see you next time as the Spirit of God directs. Have a lovely day.